Hey guys, in this video, I'm going to go over how to add and remove from binary search trees. So you can compare this to my last video that was similar, but it was adding and removing from heaps. So I'm going to do these steps sequentially, starting with add. So adding to a binary search tree is really simple. Oh, I guess I should explain briefly. So binary search trees, the parent node is always greater than all the values on the left subtree, and it's always less than all the values on the right subtree. So you can see that this is true for every node that's considered a parent node. Okay, so that was just a brief review. Okay, so adding is really simple, and it's easier, I think, than adding to heaps. So you always just add a new leaf node to binary search trees. So you never have to push anything up into the tree. You just add a new leaf, and you just want to make sure you're adding it to the correct position. So the first one we're going to do is 5. 5 is less than 6, so it would be on the left subtree of 6. So we add that leaf there, and we're done with that. 29, so let's see here, 25 or 29 is greater than 27 but less than 32, so we can add it there. And we're done with that. 33. So 33 is less than 49, but it's more than 32. So similarly, we can add it there. 10. 10 is already there. So in binary search trees, you do not add duplicates, whereas in heaps, you can. So we're done with that because 10 already is on the binary search tree. 28. 28 is less than 29, but more than 27. So we add it as a new leaf there. And we are done with adding. And then removing basically has three cases. So you can remove just one leaf that has no children, and all you have to do is remove that node. So that's one case. The second case is when you're removing a node that has one child. So for example, if we needed to remove 15, what you do in that case is you just bump up the one child to the parent node's location. So if you're removing the parent node 15, you would just remove 15 and then move up 13 to this location. And then the third case is when you remove a parent node that has two children. So for example, if we had to remove 27, we can't just bump up one of these children nodes because we have to consider which one are we moving up. So there are two options with this third case. You can either bump up the largest child in the left subtree or the smallest child in the right subtree. And this is because we want to get a value that's always going to be smaller than the right subtree. So the largest value in the left subtree will always be less than the right subtree, and the smallest value on the right subtree will always be larger than the left, any value in the left subtree. So that's kind of the idea with that, and we'll do these three examples to show you what I mean. So to remove 6, that has one child node only, so we would just remove 6 and bump up the child leaf node, and we're done with that. To remove 5, 5 now has, it's a leaf node and it has 0 children, so we could just remove 5, and we're done with that. To remove 10, so this has a child node with another child node, but it's the same thing as the case with only one child, so the only thing you would do is bump this up and make this 15, and then this would be 13. So you're really just moving this whole branch up one, and you can pretend that this is gone. I should probably be rewriting this, but hopefully you can see what's going on. And then the final case is going to be 32. So 32 is the case where you have to consider two child nodes. So in my case, I think I will just bump up the smallest value on the right subtree. So when you're doing this, you're always going to take basically the leftmost child node on the right subtree or the rightmost child node on the left subtree. So for me, the leftmost child node on the right subtree is 33, so you remove 32 and you can replace that with 33, and then remove 33, and you see that 49 is greater than 33 and 64 is greater than 49, so the right subtree still holds, and 33 is greater than 27, 29 is still less than 33, so this whole subtree is still less than 33, and we are done with this problem.